Hey, folks. I'm Joe Biden. I'm Joe President. I just want to come down and say thanks. I've worked with you for my entire career since I got involved in politics. Matter of fact, in Delaware, it used to be a joke back in the 70s when I got elected in the Senate, 1972. So there's three political parties, Democrats, Republicans, and firefighters. I have firefighters. And we're all kidding aside. The job you're doing is incredible. And, you know, most of the time, people don't really fully appreciate what you're doing until they need you. And Joe and I have had the experience of having needs. You saved my life, literally my fire department saved my life when I had two cranial aneurysms and I had to get to the hospital in the middle of a snowstorm and I had to get to Walter Reed, which was 122 miles away. She got me down the snowstorm for a 9.5-hour operation and saved my life. And when I first got to the Senate, as a 29-year-old kid, I wasn't even old enough to be sworn in yet. I had to wait a bit. And I got a phone call when I was down there hiring staff that my wife and daughter and my two boys were back at Gerald Ross at 995. And it took the jaws of life. Not 995, I misspoke. That was the next children. And it took the jaws of life almost 3 hours to save my two sons. Our two sons ended up hospitalized for a long time. And then not long after I was getting out of the hospital, I was down talking on, I was on Meet the Press, got a phone call, lightly struck my home. My wife was trapped in the home and as well as a significant portion of the furnace ground, I hit a line, a gas line, and came up through and was burned to the floor. And smoke was so thick you literally couldn't see through the window. And then crazy SOBs went in there and I quit living. Saved my wife, saved my family. And not incidentally, saved my 67 Corvette.
I want to introduce you to our battalion chief for Task Force 1.
How are you? What's your name? I just want you to know that we understand. Anybody who's ever needed to, they understand. What you're doing now is just hard as hell to deal with, even psychologically, to deal with what you're doing. I just wanted to say thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. And as you all know, it's not only what you're dealing with now, but your brothers and sisters across this country are having more pressure put on because of the drought, more pressure because of when you have 121 degrees of heat up in Vancouver, you know you got a problem. Before I was on the Zoom call yesterday with all the Western governors, and you know what they're asking for? They need more firefighters, they need more federal fighters, because, you know, last year the fire season didn't start this early, and enough places burned down, enough territory burned to the ground that's bigger than the size of Rhode Island. And already it's starting early. So you guys are, and women are really bad. And I just want to say thank you. As I said, until we need you, no one fully appreciates what you do. But I promise you, we know. We know. And what you're doing here is incredible. Having to deal with the uncertainty and worrying about you know, the families, and, you know, anyway, thank you, thank you, thank you. That's the main reason. I'm happy to try and answer any questions today, but I don't know much about what other line got briefed today, what's going on right here. Be careful.